One of the nice features of ProcessBook is the ability to import external graphic files into your displays. You can use these as indicators, enhancements to your display, or in the case I'm going to show you, as a sort of pseudo background. Even though you can't set a background image for ProcessBook, I'll show you how we might use one. I've got a simple ProcessBook display here, and what I'll do is select Draw and Graphic, and I'll draw my box on the screen. And what it's going to ask me to do is browse for the file name. I've got one on my desktop called Plant Layout, and I can either embed this document in the embed the image in the document, or I can link to it. I think I'll embed it in the document, so if I happen to move the source file, it doesn't disappear from my ProcessBook display. And you're given formatting options. You can either stretch the image to fit the rectangle that I drew, stretch the image to fit the rectangle that I drew but not skew it, retain the aspect ratio, or use the original image size, and that's what I think I'm going to do here. I'll click OK, and you'll see that I have my image on the ProcessBook display. If I go and I change the background on the ProcessBook display to a color that is the same background color as my image, then what I've done is I've created a pseudo background for my display. So I can take dynamic values and I can place them on my graphic. And we'll put a tag name here, CDT. And we'll just pick one at random and put a little trend there. We can put a little dynamic value next to other elements, and so on and so forth. And as long as I keep my graphic as the image that's furthest in the back, then it serves as a, again, a pseudo background image.